that.
It isn't unusual to see three generations of the Pickard family spending time together. But if this family had made just one different choice a few years ago, this picture could have turned out very differently. When Dr. Perry Pickard moved back to his hometown of Madison, Wisconsin, he was a man with a mission.
My career path is much different than the typical radiologist. We have a reputation for sort of being in the dark room, scurrying when the light goes on, maybe.
But Dr. Perry Pickard found himself in the spotlight as a pioneer of a new test known as virtual colonoscopy.
The main difference is the lack of invasiveness. There's no need for sticking a tube through the colon. A virtual colonoscopy is largely just a CT scan. We could fly through the colon like a video game using these advanced 3D techniques. It's pretty amazing.
Dr. Pickard brought his findings and his excitement to UW-Madison, where he found early support.
I'm a fan of virtual, which puts me in a minority of many gastroenterologists. We were concerned early on about accuracy of the test and did a study here. We've done a number of studies where we've shown this is an accurate test.
Typically, specialists like Dr. Mark Reicheldorfer perform traditional colonoscopies, in which a scope is inserted into the colon to look for polyps.
People don't like being invaded. There are people that just don't want to get it done.
Dr. Reicheldorfer saw the potential in offering patients a less invasive option.
I'm really tired of my patients dying of colon cancer. The faster we get to 100% of people being screened for colon cancer, the better.
If we can screen at least those patients that are unwilling to get a colonoscopy, we know that would have a huge impact.
Dr. Pickard and his allies took their case to local hospitals and insurance companies.
Look, we've got to screen more people. This is a way to do it. Please agree to pay for it, and they did.
So we were off and running within months after I got here to the University of Wisconsin.
This is unique in the United States. Madison, Wisconsin is a unique environment in the United States where virtual colonoscopy is paid for by all of our HMOs.
We were ready to open shop, but we had no patients. So I called up my folks.
He just asked if we would be interested in doing it, and we didn't even give it a second thought.
This was purely to help out their son with his little project.
But it quickly became much more than that. The test itself is easy.
You just lay on a table, and then you just ride through the scanner, and you're done.
It takes about 10, 15 minutes at the most. The images are then processed into this 3D model, and the patient is already back to work, back on the golf course.
His parents actually went to the grocery store while he started to read the images.
I was 90% of the way done with the fly-through. And as I took one final turn, I came upon this large mass. I knew right away this wasn't good. It's hard to put into words the feelings, that, you know, the just rushing through my head at that point.
I was told to come back to the hospital, and you can figure it's not real good.
There are those moments where you definitely break through that professional distance. I was no longer a doctor. I was looking at, you know, what something that's happening to my father. And it becomes a very personal, real thing. We didn't know at that time if it was even something that would be curable.
But Chuck Pickard was fortunate.
It wasn't an invasive cancer, and so they were able to remove it. Within a couple of years, it probably would have spread, say, most likely to the liver, and at that point, your survival plummets.
What if we hadn't discovered this? It took this colonoscopy to find that growth.
And it saved my father's life.
Though the American Cancer Society has officially recommended virtual colonoscopy as a routine method of screening for colon cancer, the test has been slow to catch on.
New technology takes a while to penetrate.
To this day, there's really not broad insurance coverage. From a national perspective, it's still considered somewhat investigational, even though there's plenty of data. I'm more than a little surprised that it's taken this long, given that we have such overwhelming evidence.
There's hope a grassroots movement can help drive change if informed patients ask for the procedure.
Patient experience has been overwhelmingly positive with this. It's not a replacement for colonoscopy. It's an additional option.
Doctors just have to become increasingly comfortable with ordering the test.
There's really no reason people should be presenting with advanced metastatic colon cancer. That's someone who could have been screened and prevented years earlier.
His father's life is a constant reminder to Dr. Pickard of what's possible. When Chuck was screened, he had no plans to get a traditional colonoscopy.
I'm not one to run into the doctor if I'm feeling well. There's no real symptoms. Had it not been taken care of when it was, it probably, it was growing, okay? So I probably wouldn't be. It's hard to say, you know, how long something like that can be with you.
It gave him another, who knows, 10, 20, 30 years of quality life that he would not have had.
I guess I can say I'm a firsthand example, you know, of what he's doing.
Success in this realm would mean taking colon cancer from the second leading cause of cancer death out of the top 10 list.
I don't want people to die from this anymore.
Get in there and have it done. And
this same thing will happen to other people. There'll be other lives saved. Every week, every month, we see similar events unfold. They're just somebody else's father or somebody else's son.
I can say that I've had quite a few good years since, you know, that could have been cut out, and looking forward to more, you know, so it's a good thing.